Today we discuss generation of programming language. First generation language. The first generation is the oldest form of computer language and machine language falls in this category. The code is written directly in zeros and one, that is the actual binary bits understandable by the computer hardware. Hence, this code needs to no translation from the user written code to machine code. This language was used in the earlier days of computer during the time of the first hardware generation, and the binary numbers were entered by means of a set of toggle switches. As the language is directly associated with the computer hardware, machine language is called low-level language. A machine language instruction usually consists of two parts. The first part is called the operation code or opcode, which tells the computer what operation or action is to be taken. Second part is called the operand, which tells the computer where to find the data to be processed or where to store the data after processing it. The advantage of first generation language: the programs written in machine language can be executed at a high speed, as this required no translation from a higher level language to binary code. A disadvantage: machine language is processor dependent, and instruction set may differ from one processor architecture to another. It is difficult or inconvenient to write or modify a program using the language. Chances of an error are more, as the programmer has to correctly remember the binary opcodes. Next, second generation language. After first generation language, the second generation of computer language was introduced when the computer were first made available commercially in early 50s. During this time, machine language gave way to more user-friendly assembly code or assembly language. The assembly language introduced in 1952 allowed programmers to use numeric code. Very important point: numeric code like LD, ADD, SUB, HALT, JMP, etc., which are easy to remember abbreviate instruction instead of binary 0 and 1. It is also known as a symbolic language. That point is very important. Mnemonic code, and second one, symbolic language. However, program written in assembly language need to be translated into machine code before this can be run by the computer. This job is done by a program called assembler. Assembly language, also known as low-level language, as it is very close to low-level machine code. Also, like machine language, different types of processor have different types of instruction sets. Hence, assembly language is also processor dependent. First generation language and second generation language, we can find, is also processor dependent. Advantage of second generation language: program written in assembly language are easier to write, modify and use as compared to machine language. An assembly language program also produces a high efficient machine language code on translation. The code written using mnemonics helps to find error in the code more easily. Advantage and disadvantage of every generation of language is very important. Disadvantage of second generation language, assembly language is also processor dependent and the instruction set may differ from one processor architecture to another. Instructions are still written using the concept of machine code, hence not an that much programmer friendly as the high level language. Next, third generation language. After first and second, third generation language is very simple than first generation and second generation. Third generation language, as the computer uses increased during 50s, it became necessary to write program that could be written much faster and with lesser error. The third generation language has the capability to support structured programming concepts. A structured programming language has defined, well-defined structure for features like branching and looping operation. These languages also have English-like phrases, commands, which make them easier to read and write. This is also portable in nature, unlike assembly language program. This means that these are independent of the processor used. Another language, first and second generation language, we find processor dependent, but in third generation language, we can see that they are independent of processor. Hence, the same source code can be used on the computer. A statement written in high-level language needs to be translated into machine code. Very important point. Translated into machine code instruction before the processor can execute it. We know the computer can read only 0 and can only 0 and 1 binary number, not high-level language like third-generation language. Translate into machine code before processor can execute it. For this, special translation program like compiler, interpreter are to be used. Third-generation language program processing to process the program language, we use compiler and interpreter. During this time, programs were basically written by scientists or engineers, not the common people. The language, algorithmic language, Fortran or the formula translation, that could mainly do mathematical operations. COBOL, common business-oriented language, Pascal, C++, etc., etc. Advantage of third generation language, programs written in high level language are easy to write, modify and use than any low level language. A program written using high level language can be run on any computer and is machine independent. The third generation language, machine independent. That's very important point. Then first generation and second generation, they are processor dependency on first generation and second generation language. A program written using a high level language can be run on any computer is machine independent. It is easy to debug the code written using a high level language. Debug means resolving error, any error of a program. That's called debugging. Translator programs like compiler and interpreter used to convert the program from high level language to machine language can also help to find an error in the code. That's point, remember it. Interpreter and compiler used to convert to machine language. Debugging means can help also help to find error in the code. It is easier to learn and master a high level language as these are very close to the language we speak, like English. The programmer does not have to know about the internal structure of the processor to write the program using a high level language. Also, disadvantage of third generation language, program written using high level language needs to be translated to machine before it can use. Okay, very important. A program written using high level language needs to be translated to machine language before it can be executed. We use like interpreter, compiler here. The translated code requires more space, needs more time to execute than the corresponding program written in assembly language. The efficiency of a program written in a high level language can be less than that written using the low level language. Next generation, fourth generation, but 4GL. Fourth generation language are usually special purpose language that are easier to use than third generation language. Whereas third generation language are usually meant for professional programmer, fourth generation language can be learned and used quickly by non-professional. That's point. Third generation language used by efficient programmer, but 4GL language use any programming language, they can use 4GL language by non-professional programs as well. Thus, application can be developed much faster using 4GL language. Third generation language, the program usually specifies the steps of procedure that the program should follow to solve problem. In contrast, in 4GL, the program does not have to specify the procedure in details, but specify the requirements or objective. Hence, 4GL are non-procedural, but nature in procedural is third generation language. The programmer has to specify what is required, how it to be done. Fourth generation language are so user friendly that with couple of days training and practice, a competent person can learn to write program, make inquiries, generation desired reports. These languages are also database friendly. That is, they can use easily input data, query data, generation report from the database. SQL, that's example. Advantage of fourth generation, it makes lesser time to develop a program using a 4GL compared to the previous generation of language. The cost and overhead of developing software using 4GL is less. The machine code generated by such a language after translation may not be most efficient code as compared to language of the previous generation. That's disadvantage of fourth generation language. Now we use fifth generation language, 5GL. Fifth generation language, also non-procedural language. This language solve a programming problem based on a set of conditions entered by the programmer. This is unlike the 4GLs, which are designed to build specific program based the programmer requirement. A 5GL simply makes the computer solve the problem. These languages are usually used in area like artificial intelligence, very important, AI, fifth generation language. Programming in logic, in such language which is used to solve complex logic problems, it uses a special type of logic notation called predicate calculus for communication with the computer. The program uses set of facts and set of rules express the problem. Next, a query is made to the get required database. These rules. Advantage of fifth generation language. It does not need for the program to understand the algorithm to solve the problem. Disadvantage. fifth generation language can be used effectively for a relatively small application area. So there are two types of language, low level and high level. Machine language, assembly language and high level language we discuss, among advantage and disadvantage of these languages. Okay, thank you.